In this video, you'll see part 3 of how to create a container product on AWS Marketplace. By listing your container on AWS Marketplace, you can grow your customer base, protect your product's intellectual property, and improve efficiency and reliability. This video is part 3 of a 3-part series. In part 1, we saw how to create a container product for AWS Marketplace and publish it in a limited state. In part 2, we reviewed an API integration needed for a pricing model and built a container image for uploading it to AWS Marketplace. In this segment, we'll see how to publish and unpublish a public listing for a container product in AWS Marketplace. We'll begin in the AWS Marketplace Management Portal on the Server Products page. Our listing is in a limited state right now, so it isn't visible to the outside world. To make it public, we'll need to add a new version. We can do that from here or from the product page. Let's open the product page. From here, we can verify the product ID and product code and request a change to add a new version. We'll enter a version title that will be visible to buyers and provide some release notes. Next, we'll add a delivery option. We can have buyers launch our product using a Helm chart or a container image. We'll provide a container image. We'll provide the URL for our container image, which is hosted in a repository in Amazon Elastic Container Registry. We can add up to 50 container images to a delivery option. Likewise, if we select the Helm chart method, we can add up to 50 container images and use a single Helm chart to deploy any dependency order that we want. For our purposes, we'll add a single container image to this product version, and we won't use a Helm chart. We can provide a title, description, and instructions for the delivery option. If we want, our instructions can include the specific commands needed to deploy the product after it's purchased. In this case, we'll provide plain text instructions. Next, we'll select the services in which the buyer can launch the container. For this version, we'll select Amazon Elastic Container Service, or ECS. If we were using a Helm chart, we might select Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or EKS. We have the option to add up to 4 deployment templates. These are CloudFormation templates for resources that buyers can use to launch the product. In this case, we won't be adding any. Let's submit this request. The request is now under review by the AWS Marketplace Operations team. We can monitor its status on the Requests History page. The request should be complete within minutes. Once the request is successful, we can preview our product from the Products page. Let's view how the product will look to buyers in AWS Marketplace. Right now, there are placeholder values here. Next, let's update the information associated with the new version. To do that, we'll request a change. Let's replace the placeholder text with the title and descriptions we want buyers to see. We can also update the product logo URL, as well as the highlights content that will be shown on the right side of the product page. Let's go ahead and update the highlights. We can choose up to 3 product categories for our listing. We can also add keywords that buyers might use when searching to help them find this product. We can add up to 3 additional resources, such as white papers and product sheets. We can also include 1 URL for a video demonstrating the product. Finally, we can provide support information. Let's submit the changes. Under Request Status, we can see that the changes are being applied. It will take a few minutes before they'll be reflected on the product page. We can also monitor the status of the request on the Requests History page. Let's go back into this request. The product page now shows the updated product information for the new version. At any time, we can edit the changes that we requested. Now let's see how to publish this product version to AWS Marketplace. From here, we'll contact the AWS Marketplace Operations team. We'll complete a support request with our contact information and some information about our listing. We'll provide our product code and ask the Marketplace operations team to publish it. Once our product has been published, buyers will be able to find it in AWS Marketplace. Let's search for our product. Here it is. Buyers can view the product and subscribe. Next, let's look at a few other changes that can be requested. We can update the AWS regions where the product can be deployed. The current list of regions was provided when we filled out the product load form, or PLF. While we are currently unable to update the list from the product page, we can upload an updated PLF, which will create a support request with AWS Marketplace. Similarly, it is not currently possible to unpublish a product from the product page. If we need to take down the product, we can contact the AWS Marketplace Seller Operations Team by submitting a support request. We also have the option to update the version information. From this page, we can select the version we want to update. Here is the information we can modify. We can update the version title, release notes, and container image. We can't change the delivery method, but we can change the container image if necessary. We can also update the delivery option title and description, as well as the usage instructions and supported services. We can also add a deployment template. As with other requests, version update requests can be tracked on the Requests History page. This completes the process of creating a publicly listed container product. You've just seen part 3 of how to create a container product in AWS Marketplace. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.